poet I'm gonna call to the stage. She traveled the furthest distance. She come all the way from Boston. Boston's in the building, you know what I mean? Real heavy. She performed with us at the 1 year anniversary. That was her first time, and now this is her second time back. All the way from Boston. And she's gonna do her thing, and she's gonna go right back to Boston. So that's a lot of love. So I'm gonna call her to the stage right now. She goes by the name of Eclipse. Put your hands together for Eclipse. All the way from Boston.
All right. Thank you, Show Off Entertainment. If y'all ever wanna come to Boston, we have a Poetic Escape. Anytime you come down, let me know. We'll gladly have y'all. And Miss Busybody made me blush. And I write sexual shit, so. This is nothing to do with sex, but I feel Obama won. I could hear the pen start writing as poets, so this is my political piece, all right?
Speak.
As doctors research facts and anecdotes, I'm trying to find an antidote. Trying to continue the poem that our ancestors wrote in language that only speaks to poor and broken people who may not speak English, but they can understand peaceful because they have survived this place. Now black, proud, single mothers and fathers are no longer epidemics. They can look at their sons and daughters' brown faces and say, yes, hope is infinite. We lost sight of democracy somewhere in the philosophy of I'ma do me while you do you. Which makes it hard. So now I can't even date a guy unless he shows me his voter registration card. Because wow. I can't vote, and we all know the boat that I came on does not give me the rights of this soil. So for those born into political freedom and not using it, that makes my blood boil. But I've still survived this place. It's a societal system based on conquering by division, trying to subtract our persistence by multiplying our afflictions. See, I'm not afraid of the inevitable battles in the political locked doors, because I've stocked up enough ramen noodles and mac and cheese to last me 3 world wars. I'm ready to survive this place. And yeah, I know most of us grew up never having enough, but then you get a little bit of dough and it's gone in a puff. The old generation broke down doors we couldn't enter. Our generation thinks success is a couch from Rent-A-Center. Learn to survive with grace. And yes, some say our people were enslaved because we were the sinners, forgetting that these hands built the homes that got them through the coldest of winters. Now my people go hungry and start eating their dreams for breakfast and dinners, trying to survive this place. And I thank you, Mr. Black President-elect, the ultimate go-getter. And he's not the answer to our questions, but it sure makes asking them feel a lot better. And I know that I don't even like coffee, but I drank it that morning because I just wanted something black and heated running through my veins again. And revolution, see, that word's too big, it makes my head spin. I want to start with smaller words like love and action, something we can actually sink our teeth in. I just want us to wake up from this silly hibernation and ask ourselves daily, what did I do today to inspire the next generation? And this one is kind of about sex. I used to be like the bitter black girl who hacks into her boyfriend's MySpace to check who he's leaving comments for.
Crazy!
Yeah. Yeah. That's when I had a bad name. Got one of those, crazy. Got quick, no good, don't even try to like rehab him, pray for him, not working. Now I have a good man, so I did want to write a bad man, good man poem. So if you can relate to the first half of it, I'm sorry. And if you can relate to the second, more power to you. So, I had a man who was bad and who treated me worse. I tried to convince myself he was good and was putting me first. To the public eye, he was perfect and always on the level. In public, he's so bad, I played wife swap with the devil. Someone left him out on the table and he got sour and curdled. I spent weekends avoiding the emotional blows he hurled. It's not like asking for sensitivity would shatter his core. When I cry, he don't hold me. He asks, what's this bitch crying for? Someone messed him up and gave him refurbished intimacy. And our love's on trial like Johnny Cochran, I'm trying to prove his legitimacy. Asking him who raped your innocence, left you open, naked, and empty. Like a fool, I forgave him. When he cheated, I didn't blame him. He lied, and I blamed it on my lack of communication. Wow. He showed up smelling like Victoria's Secret love spell. He said, I went to Victoria's Secret to buy you a gift, or some shit. 2 weeks, 7 days later, and an hour counting, I still haven't seen this gift. And I found a text on his phone. He said it was his cousin playing games. But the number's listed under nice ass, and that don't sound like no cousin's name. And I learned to fill his needs and camouflage the pain. Took control of my wild oats, and he had me tame. I learned to laugh the way he liked, speak the way he liked, dress the way he liked, till he changed the shit he liked. Mm-hmm. And now my relationship with God suffers, because I can't reach my own spirit. And I pray sometime, and God's already answered, I just refuse to hear it. See, I used to get down on my knees and ask for daily bread. With him, I only got down on my knees when he asked for daily help. So I checked, and no wonder I'm malnourished. So I checked myself into a newfound purpose, and this heart is now an imaginary place where I've been living in disgrace. And I was afraid to lose him because my mama said, well, one woman won't do, another one will. I said, fuck it, let another girl swallow that trifling swill. Because now I got a good man who wants me in his life and puts me in his plan. Our love is like ADHD. I'm the first and last of his attention span. Byproduct of the strongest, baddest neighborhoods, and the only argument we really have is where I be hiding his backwards. Well, he's not perfect on any standard or scale. When I breathe in, it's only him I exhale. Haitian and country, and he doesn't fit into any American plan. He's confident in himself. He does not need to show me his dick to prove he's a man. And to see this brother naked, you know why I'm a fiend. I'm like the Bonnie to his Clyde. He holds a straight razor, I got his Vaseline. And sometimes I be on some slim fan fatal attraction hype where I secretly wish he'd get sick, need a blood transfusion, and I'd be the only one to match his blood type. I hear a man's as faithful as given options, that's the come off. So I cancel Verizon and Comcast to keep him away from my space jump offs. And with his dreads let out, he reminds me of a lion. So our bedroom becomes a safari. And I become helpless prey, pretending to run away, but I always let that nigga catch me. Ladies, we stay looking for the Prince Charming, but that prince likes men in the least. I skip the prince bullshit and his beauty. I went straight for the beast. And it's not only sexual, although I can't complain, but this man opens his mouth and he seduces my brain. Remembers birthdays, favorite colors, compliments my weave, and the things that make me smile. And I shed a tear, he holds me and let me be vulnerable for a while. Now when I get down on my knees, it's to consecrate and pray. I'll still get down on my knees, but that just kind of depends on the day.